Hello guys, welcome back to a new video here on my channel. Today I'm giving you a first impression of some new paper I recently got. So this is a Fabriano Black paper. It's drying paper and it is 300 grams per square meter, so very heavy drying paper. I don't think it's meant for a specific kind of medium. So today I'm using my colored pencils on it. So I'm using a combination of my Faber-Castell Polychromos again, and then one white Caran d'Ache Luminance. And I just wanted to try it out and tell you what I think of it and give you a bit of a review. So let's get started. Today I am drawing a jellyfish. I wanted to draw something simple but also something bright and colorful, so I thought let's try to draw a jellyfish on this. So I started out with sketching the outlines with my white Polychromos, and then right away I noticed that this paper is quite rough, so it has quite a rough texture, and my Polychromos felt pretty scratchy on it. But as soon as I started to use the white Caran d'Ache for the sketch as well, I noticed that that one went a lot smoother on it. So that's something I noticed right away. That's probably because the Caran d'Ache are more wax based and contain a higher amount of wax than the Polychromos, so they are a bit softer, which means that they will probably layer more easily on this paper. So that's the first thing I noticed. And then after sketching, I started out with laying down some colors. So with my Polychromos, I picked out a bright pink and I just glazed that on top of the white areas. I also, I already put in some value with the white, so I already marked in the white areas, the brightest areas. And then I just went over it with the pink to see how well it would layer down. And with that pink as well, I noticed that it felt a bit scratchy. It can be the color itself. Some colors are a bit firmer, are a bit scratchier than others. So this pink might just be a bit scratchy. But this paper definitely has a bit more texture than what I'm used to when I work with colored pencils. So that's something to take notice of. If you like textured paper, this is definitely a good paper for you. And because of the heaviness, I also think it's very suitable for mixed media. So I might also try it out with pastel pencils or even watercolors maybe. So after I laid down the base layer of pink, I went on with adding some blues and adding some darker pinks just to see how many layers I could lay down before the paper would get saturated. And I did notice that the paper got saturated a bit quick, so I couldn't layer down a lot of different layers before I noticed that the paper really got rid of the texture, so I couldn't really add a lot of layers. And especially when I added the white Caran d'Ache again on top of the Polychromos layers I put down, after that it was really hard to put down any more layers of the Polychromos. So it might take some practice for me to be able to really handle this paper well, but for the first try I think this jellyfish turned out pretty okay. I was hoping for a really smooth finish, but because of the texture, I couldn't really achieve a really smooth finish. So that is something I didn't really like, but it also has a bit of a smoother side on the back of the paper. So it has two sides, one a textured side, and then the back side is usually a bit more smooth. So my first impression of this is that I think it's really versatile because of the texture and the heaviness. It is different than what I'm used to, but I do think you can achieve really detailed work on this if you work with really sharp pencils. So for wildlife, it might be really cool. Also, I'm planning on doing a white on black drawing with this, so a drawing with just white colored pencil on this black paper, and I think it's really suitable for that. So stay tuned for a detailed wildlife piece in white on this paper, so I'm really excited for that. If you're working with Prismacolors or with Caran d'Ache, so with the more wax-based pencils, I think you'd have a more easier time with layering and blending. For the Polychromos, it does feel a bit scratchy, but definitely not annoying. It is something to get used to. The colors do feel really opaque on it, so you can achieve really nice effects on this paper. So I'm definitely planning on doing some more practice on it and using it more often. This video is not sponsored, by the way, so I bought this paper myself. One of my followers suggested it to me, and I've always really liked doing drawings on black paper, but so far I had only used the Canson Mitens pastel paper, but that's not a paper I really like. Definitely not for colored pencil. For pastel pencils it's okay, but for a colored pencil it's not. So this paper is a good addition to my collection of materials, and I'll be using it more often. And then I want to thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. Also, don't forget to share it with your friends if you think this video was informational. And then I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.